This video will run through how to set up the PADS Professional Starter Library that you have downloaded to make sure that you can use it with your designs. First, you need to unzip the contents of the zip folder and place it somewhere on your computer. I usually place the library in the C drive of my computer. If you put it somewhere else, take note of where it will be so you can find the files you need in the following steps. The complete starter library is located in this folder. However, in order to use the parts there in the library, we need to set up an ODBC or Open Database Connectivity driver for the corresponding databook database. This is important because all of the component properties for the parts in the library are in this database. Open the ODBC Data Source Administrator and make sure to open the 64-bit version. Notice that there is an entry for Starter Library here. However, do not let this confuse you. We are setting up a different library. Now, click Add. In this next dialog box, there is a very good chance that the Microsoft Access ODBC driver we need is not here. So we need to download the driver from the Microsoft website. In a browser, search for the Microsoft Access ODBC driver 64-bit. Find the Microsoft.com website that allows you to download the driver. Click Download and select the 64-bit version of the Access Database Engine and click Next. Once downloaded, install the driver. Now that the driver is installed, it should be available for us to use. So go back to the ODBC Source Administrator dialog and click Add. Next, choose the Microsoft Access driver. Make sure to use the driver for the .mdb files. In the following window, add the data source name. You need to call it PADS Pro VX_library, otherwise setup becomes much more complicated. Then add a description if you want, and click the Select button and navigate to the databook.mdb file that came with the starter library download, located in the DX Databook Data folder. With the ODBC driver set up, we can start to use the library in a design. So let's create a new design so I can show you how to make sure you're using the starter library in your next design. I will use the start page of the tool to create a quick project. During the creation of the project, users always point to the central library that they want to use, so in this case, I will point to the new library by browsing and selecting the associated PADS Pro VX.lmc file. Now that I've given my project a name and pointed to a central library, I'll create the project. Once the project is open, choose Setup Settings from the top menu. And on the left-hand side of the Settings dialog box, under Project and PADS Databook, set the Databook Configuration file to the .dbc file located in the DX Databook Data folder of the newly installed library. Pointing to this file saves you a ton of time, as it will configure Databook for you. If you used a different name than PADS Pro VX_library for the ODBC driver, you will probably see an error soon, since the DBC file references that name specifically to set up Databook. Now that you have set up the DBC file, you should be able to access the different libraries that are a part of the database and place any of the 10,000 parts that are in the starter library from Databook.